Mustafa Sungur's defense. To Afyon Criminal Court. The prosecution wants to have me punished for belonging to the society of Nurcus and inciting the people against the government. Firstly, there is no society called the Nurcus Society, and I belong to no such society. I am a member of the sacred, divine society of Islam, which every century for 1,350 years has had 300 million members, was founded by Muhammad, upon whom be blessings and peace, the glory of the universe, and is vast and luminous, and promises eternal happiness for all mankind. All thanks be to God, I am determined to obey its sacred injunctions with all my strength. As for the Risale-i Nur, my being a student of which is considered to be a crime, it is a miracle of the Quran that teaches me my religious duties and those related to belief, and that Islam is the highest and most sacred religion and the sole means of happiness for mankind. It proves with brilliant evidences that the Quran is a decree of the All Glorious One, who is the owner of all beings, is all present and all seeing everywhere, and under whose pre-eternal administration are all beings from minute particles to the stars and suns. It is a miraculous work whose view encompasses pre-eternity and post-eternity and all events. It is the pre-eternal address of an everlasting sun, which is superior to all other books and miraculous in 40 aspects, and which, by giving mankind the good news of eternal happiness, is the object of their eternal gratitude. It proves, too, that God's messenger, upon whom be blessings and peace, was sent by the Creator of the universe, and that with all his conduct and practices was the most perfect, the most loyal, the highest of all men, whose perfections were the most elevated, and through the light of Islam that he brought, gave the best of all news to men, and gave them the most sacred consolation, and who has taken under his spiritual rule 14 centuries and 1/5 of mankind, and to the book of whose good deeds passed the equivalent of all the good deeds performed for 1,300 years by his community, and that he is the reason for the universe's existence and is God's beloved. It proves also with brilliant proofs that both the hereafter and paradise and hell are certain and definite. With its words and sentences, the Risale-i Nur testifies that it is a pre-eternal and post-eternal light proceeding from the light of the Quran and the light of Muhammad, upon whom be blessings and peace. In respect of its belonging to the Quran and being a special commentary on it, it pertains to the heavens and the divine throne. Thus, with all its words, all its flashes and rays, and all its letters, the Risale-i Nur, which is supposed to be inciting the people against the government, teaches the divine truths and principles of Islam and mysteries of the Quran. Is it a crime, then, to read the Risale-i Nur, which is thus elevated and worthy of veneration, and teaches good morality and virtue and the truths of belief, and to copy out its parts, which bestow eternal happiness, or to serve it so that believers may profit from it with respect to their belief? Is that inciting the people against the government? And to visit the author of such a blessed and sublime work, a monument of light who is decked out with the highest degree of belief, laudable morals and virtue, and is at the very summit of human perfections, and to be brothers on the way of the Quran and belief with the Risale-i Nur students, who with their good works, veracity, and unshakable belief this century have defended the honor of Islam and truths of the Quran and upheld them, and who have no aim other than winning God's pleasure, is to do these things to found a political society which equitable, unsullied conscience could inflict a punishment for this. Judges of the court. The Risale-i Nur's veracity has been affirmed by the most advanced scholars, and with its gaining for its readers the highest level of belief and greatest love of Islam, there is no doubt that all its words and its flashes and rays are luminous commentaries on the Quran of miraculous exposition. They are all brilliant suns which dispel spiritual sicknesses and darkness. As is testified to by his pure and upright life, our master has passed his life on the way of belief and the Quran, and enduring every sort of difficulty and distress, has by disseminating the truths of the Quran worked to save the sons of this blessed nation, in particular from the awesome attacks of communism and every sort of irreligion, and was charged with the sacred duty of writing the Risale-i Nur at this time. He does not instruct us, God forbid, in immorality and spoliation. He teaches us the saving of belief, the highest cause and most momentous question in the world of humanity. It is most certainly a divine favor that for 25 to 30 years he has striving with the Risale-i Nur to save the religious belief of hundreds of thousands of believers, especially by teaching belief the greatest happiness in life and its most important purpose to unfortunates like myself who knew nothing of Islam. We say the following to those who in a way diametrically opposed to reality, consider him to be harmful for the life of society, and deny his sacred service of belief and work for religion. If it is a crime to adhere to God and obeying the injunctions of religion, save people from terrible calamities such as immorality and being without religious belief, and to make them happy with the permanent happiness of Islam, then he may be said to be harmful to society. It is otherwise the greatest calumny and an unforgivable crime. The Risale-i Nur's aim is not this world, it is the never-ending happiness of the hereafter, and the pleasure of the eternal enduring one, the compassionate one of beauty, one shadow of the manifestation of whose beauty is all the beauty and good in this world, and one flesh of whose love is paradise together with all of its subtle wonders. Having a thus divine, sacred, and truly elevated aim, a thousand times over I declare the Risale-i Nur to be free of all transitory things, such as inciting the people against the government. And we seek refuge with God from the evil of those who with slander of this sort try to crush us and prevent us from working for belief or from learning about religion. Judges of the Court. As is indicated by 33 verses of the Quran and pointed out by Imam Ali, may God be pleased with him, and Ghafsul Azam, may God be pleased with him, and hundreds of investigative scholars, the Risale-i Nur is a light of the Quran, those who adhere to which will save their belief, God willing. It most definitely cannot be extinguished or be lost. For example, the attacks made on it these last 25 years with the intention of eliminating it have been the cause of its spreading and shining out in extraordinary fashion. For its owner is the all-glorious monarch, in whose power and under whose commands is everything from pre-eternity to post-eternity. For its truths are the Quran's truths, and through his protection and grace, and mighty God will always make it shine out, God willing. Judges of the Court. If it is a crime to read and write out the Risale-i Nur, which teaches belief and Islam with the highest love and fervor, and recognizes no aim or purpose other than divine pleasure, and is certainly a supreme miracle of the Quran, this age, and a luminous commentary on it, and to give its treatises, which teach the truths of belief, to one's believing brother, and if the bonds of religion and Islamic brotherhood, which are enjoined by religion and the sacred, divine fraternity of uniting on the way of the Quran, and belief for love of God constitute a political society, for me to belong to such a society is the greatest good fortune and is a happiness greater than that afforded by any favor or award. And with thanks be to Almighty God, who bestowed on a wretch like myself the great favor of being a Risale-i Nur student, which gains such happiness and good fortune for a person. My last word is, for us, God suffices, and He is the best disposer of affairs. God suffices me, there is no God but He, in Him do I place my trust, He, the sustainer of the throne of glory supreme. Mustafa Sungur, Teacher. Mustafa Sungur's Supplement for the Court of Appeal. 1. The Criminal Court. My reading the Risale-i Nur and writing it out and giving a part of it to a needy believing brother so that he might benefit from it was called inciting the people against the garment and deemed an offense. However, in my written objections to this charge, I said, the Risale-i-Nur, which is supposed to incite the people against the garment, is a true Quranic commentary. With all its parts, it teaches the truths of belief and bestows the greatest happiness on those who read and write it. Its aim is not anything transitory such as inciting the people against the garment, the way of disruptive, immoral layabouts. It is divine pleasure, the most perfect of all happiness and good fortune. I am proud to read and write out the Risale-i-Nur, which has gained for me the highest virtue and belief, the sweetest bounty, so that I am its luckiest student and most powerless servant. Although I said that I knew to be its student was a supreme divine gift, and that I constantly thank my sustainer who granted this vast bounty to a wretch like myself who was not worthy of it, without basing it on any law or evidence, my adherence to belief in Islam was deemed a crime, and entirely contrary to truth and right, I was punished. 2. While studying in Kastamonu Gölköy Institute, I myself witnessed the irreligion taught us by some teachers. They said, God forbid, that the Prophet Muhammad, upon whom be blessings and peace, had written the Quran, Islam was now abrogated, civilization had advanced, and that it was a great error and backwardness to follow the Quran this century. One day even, a teacher said that because Muslims performed the obligatory prayers and thought of the hereafter, they suffered constant distress and passed their lives unhappily, and that in the mosques of Islam there was a death atmosphere, while the Christian churches were always happy and full of life, and that with their musical instruments and other amusements, they enjoyed life and passed their time happily. They tried to break the bonds with Islam and belief in our hearts and instill denial and disbelief in their place. Then, if by reading several treatises from a peerless light of the Quran, like the Risale-i-Nur, which pours out from the Quran's effulgence and proves with brilliant evidences and arguments the truths of belief in Islam, and that the religion of Islam is a never-dying, inextinguishable sun and means whereby humanity may attain happiness and well-being, a wretch in whom had been instilled the above poisonous ideas and whose spirituality they had wanted to kill with their noxious irreligious lessons and had even been carried away by them, and God forbid, believing in those ideas had begun to disseminate them, if he had come to believe in the Quran, would not his offering the endless joy and happiness he felt to the compassionate, loyal, and true hero Ustad Bediüzzaman, who had gained this for him through the blessed Risale-i-Nur he had written, would not his telling the revered master, who had been charged with the burdensome duty of writing the Risale-i-Nur, how it had saved him from his former life of heedlessness and misguidance, leading him to belief and light, and how it was a sun of guidance and means of happiness for all humanity, and a divine favor for all men, and particularly for believers, and would not his calling, the destruction and corruption of a coward organization of the Sufyan, those who with their terrible aggressive assaults on the Quran and Islam, as described above, were urging the sons of this heroic Muslim nation to embrace irreligion and trying to raise the sacred, divine foundations of Islam, to whom millions of people are bound and destroy their eternal happiness, and feeling compounded regrets and disgust at the lunatics who applaud them and their base, aggressive, tyrannical destruction, and would not his saying to his former fellow students, who had fallen into doubt concerning their faith, come, let's give up following the lusts and whims of our souls, let's bow before the truths of the Quran and hurry to the Risale-i-Nur Madrasa, the guide to happiness this century. Let's leave those lying scoundrels whom we have been applauding for months or years, and reject the falsehoods they show to be the truth, and attach ourselves to Bediüzzaman Said Nursi's teachings and take them as our master. Let's turn our backs on the darkness and embrace the light. Would not this all arise from the joy he found in his belief and his love of the Quran and Islam and from his adherence to them and his devotion to his nation and his desiring everyone to acquire true, affirmative belief and attain infinite happiness? Is it a crime to attach oneself to God and proclaim that Islam is the loftiest religion and the bringer of virtue and happiness? At a time when with lies and slander from every side there are overwhelming attacks on the Quran and Islam and attempts are being made to refute the Quran and Muhammad, upon whom the blessings and peace, which are extremely elevated, sacred, and precious, yet books which spread irreligion and atheism and rebellious, transcend, worthless, wretches who attack Islam are held in respect and innovations and the unlawful are applauded. At such a time, is it a crime to believe and proclaim the sacredness and loftiness of the Risale-i Nur and that, as a miracle of the Quran, it is a divine light and dominical gift which explains and proves decisively and clearly the elevateness, veracity, and sacredness of the Quran and Muhammad, upon whom be blessings and peace, and both God's existence, and that the universe with all its beings and all its members and systems testifies to its creator's necessary existence and unity, and because he possesses reason and can think and is the most comprehensive mirror of the divine names, man is a sort of monarch over all other creatures, and that if he has a relationship with God through worship and belief and preserves himself against misguidance and vice and grievous sins, he becomes worthy of rising to the highest of the high, superior to all beings, and an esteemed guest who will be forever happy in paradise. But if he denies his creator through associating partners with him and rebellion, or through heedlessness and misguidance, he falls lower than an animal, descending to the lowest of the low, coming to deserve everlasting hell and unending torment and torture, and that the Quran is the true word of God, which is constant, and that its injunctions and commands do not and cannot change, and that mankind's true and permanent happiness is possible only through following the Quran's commands and adhering to them. It is not considered a crime to read novels and stories written against Islam for 5 or 10 minutes illicit pleasure, or to publish books extremely dangerous and harmful for the country and nation, and to praise and recommend them. So can it be deemed a crime if we read and write out the Risale-i Nur, which describes the Son of Islam, which hundreds of millions of people have followed, and in which they have found true happiness, or enumerate its elevated characteristics, which we lack the ability to praise? Can anyone who has an atom of belief in his heart and desires the well-being of the country and nation consider the above to be crimes? Respected judges of the appeal court, this case presented in your elevated presence is directly the case of belief and the Quran. It is the case of the eternal happiness and salvation of millions of people. Concerned with this case in effect are foremost God's most noble messenger, upon whom be blessings and peace, and all the prophets, peace be upon them, and all the saints and innumerable people of reality and believers, as well as all our forefathers who have departed for the eternal realm. You may now win the love and goodwill, the prayers and intercession of those millions of the people of reality. The elevated reality called the Risale-i Nur is before you. Is its aim the lowly, transcend ranks and positions of this world, or to win God's pleasure, the greatest happiness, the purest joy, and highest good fortune? And does it encourage people to be immoral, or does it deck them out with belief and the highest morality and virtue? Before you is the Risale-i Nur, which pours out from the miraculousness of the Quran of miraculous exposition and is a divine light. Since the greatest case facing people, more important than anything, is to win belief in order to be able to depart from this world for the realm of eternal happiness. And since, through the effulgence of the Quran, the Risale-i-Nur teaches the truths of belief, and as is testified to by hundreds of thousands of people who have read it and written it out, and as indicated by numerous Quranic verses and hadiths of the Prophet, upon whom be blessings and peace, and Imam Ali, may God be pleased with him, and many saints like Ghafsul Azam, may God be pleased with him, it has definitely won that case, certainly and without doubt, by virtue of your elevated love of truth and justice, above every sort of transcendent anxiety, you will understand and appreciate the Risale-i-Nur's veracious Quranic face and its true value, and that its students pursue no aim other than God's pleasure. Judges of the Appeal Court. With his high morality, virtue, and compassion, our esteemed and elevated master, Bediüzzaman Said Nursi, strives to save people from the dense darkness of false ideas and eternal solitary confinement, and enduring the severest distress and torments, has risen to the highest degree of perfection, at this time being charged by Almighty God with the sacred duty of publishing the truths of the Quran, yet, entirely contrary to all truth and justice, he is cast into prison. Elderly, ill, and with no one, practicing his beliefs and worship in most elevated fashion, possessing the most brilliant intelligence and learning, and having no aim other than saving the belief of people, the terrible suffering of our master, who is 75 years old and truly loves humanity, in the intense cold of Afyon prison, pierces the heart, causing the severest anguish. Trusting in your elevated truth, loving justice, and truth philanthropy, we await the manifestation of justice's compassion. Mustafa Sungur. Mehmet Feyzi's defense to Afyon Criminal Court. The indictment states that I am my master, Said Nursi's chief scribe, and am firmly attached both to himself and to the Risale-i-Nur, and have served them, and it deems this an offense. For my part, I accept the charge with all my strength, and am proud of it. For I have a powerful, innate yearning for knowledge. Evidence for this is that when during the Denizli affair, my house was searched, it was officially established that found in it were more than 500 various scholarly books, some in Arabic. It is an unusual desire to study, an extraordinary love of learning that made me collect these 500 books that not one person in a thousand would have at this time, despite my impecuniosity and young years. Because of this natural capacity of mine, I was searching for a true master. And with thanks be to Almighty God that He gave me what I was searching for ever from close by. Yes, my master, Said Nursi's life testifies that his only aim in life has been knowledge and to learn the sciences of Islam. I have understood clearly, both through my own observations and from his published biography, and from what I have learned from his old students, the innate love of learning that I have is found in my master to an extraordinary degree, so that, on his own in wondrous fashion, contrarily to all the other madrasa teachers at this time, he has persisted in madrasa teaching and endured every calamity. But then, because they did not understand my master's extraordinary situation, the politicians attempted to link him with a sort of politics with which he has no connection, even throwing him into prison. But later, Almighty God made his passion for knowledge into a key to the Quran's truths, and the Risale-i-Nur emerged, which has left all scholars and philosophers in amazement. Around that time, as a divine favor, I found close by Inkastamonu, the master I had been searching for all my life, whose nature was similar to mine, but infinitely more elevated. I shall offer thanks for this to the end of my days. Just as since early days, in order to preserve the dignity of learning, My master never accepted such things as charity and gifts, so he did not allow his students to accept them. He would bow before no one. In fact, not condescending to crouch down in the trenches in the front lines in the war, or even to enter them, he preserved the dignity of learning. Similarly, heroically preserving the honor of scholarship and teaching in the face of three awesome commanders, he was completely unmoved at their anger and silenced them. I therefore accepted him as my true master, since I knew that he was someone who had sacrificed everything to preserve the high honor of this nation and country and the Turkish learned establishment. Even if to suppose the impossible a master so truly devoted to his country and nation had 100 faults, they should be looked on tolerantly and not objected to. An example showing that this country's patriots in the second constitutional period and the nationalists and patriots under the Republic appreciated in the name of the country and nation our master's extraordinary service to learning was that the Committee of Union and Progress governments gave 19,000 gold liras for his university in the East called the Medrese-i Zehra. This was to be organized along the same lines of El Eser University. Its foundations were laid in one province, but it remained unbuilt due to the First World War. Then, the first government of the Republic, 24 years ago, allotted 150,000 liras on the agreement of 163 deputies. Our master's nearly succeeding on his own in founding a large university similar to El Eser, which was brought into being only through the enterprise of thousands of teachers, shows that all patriots and lovers of their country, together with the teachers of the madrasas, religious schools, should appreciate and applaud him. As for us, because we found such a master, we decided to endure every sort of hardship and difficulty. I have boundless respect for him as an exceptionally learned scholar at this time, who through the effulgence of his learning and truths of his 130 works has caused me to advance on the way of belief and knowledge. God willing, this respect of mine will continue for all eternity. There is no coward organization which exploiting religion and religious feelings aims to breach public security in connection with which the prosecution wants to have me convicted. Despite months of investigations and searches, it has not been able to verify any such society, nor do we have any connection with such a thing. Our sole concern within the framework of the laws of the Republic is for the Risale-i-Nur, which has undergone the toughest examinations and has met with due respect from the highest committees of experts and has been acquitted by authorized courts of law. This is not treason towards the country and nation, but scholarly striving in a way that is directly beneficial for country and nation. Other than this, we have no political aim nor any other purpose. Thus, since our innocence and sincerity are clear in this matter, I seek the manifestation of justice from your just court and my acquittal as in Denizli court. Prisoner, Kastamonulu Mehmet Feyzi Pamukçu, Afyon Prison.